guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we have a foundation review on the new Natasha Denona Foundation X. I ordered this the day that it released, and I got it about 2 days after, and I have been wearing it every single day since then to try it out and to test it out for a review for you guys. This is what the packaging looks like. It's very simple white packaging, and then it has her colors right there on the bottom. I have the lightest shade, it's number 10. Like I said, I have been wearing this foundation for probably a little over a week. So far, it's been working out quite nicely. I'm gonna go ahead and jump right into the demo, and then after the demo's done, I will be back and I will tell you guys all the information that you would want to know about it. For this part, I am going to be using a little bit of pore filler. So this is the Makeup Forever Step 1 Equalizer and Smoothing. I find that for me that this works best with a pore filling primer, as it doesn't necessarily it doesn't make your pores look bigger and it doesn't sink into them, but it doesn't just glide over and fill them in either. So I prefer to put a pore filling primer just in that area. Other than that, I don't have any other primers on today. I just have my normal skincare. Like with most foundations, I do prefer to apply it with my beauty blender, so that's what I'm gonna go in with today. I find that a brush gives you decent coverage, but brushes just never work with me. They tend to leave streaks in my foundation, so I just prefer the beauty blender overall. So that's what I'm gonna go in with today. The shade, I really like this shade for me. It's a warmer shade, but it matches me really, really well. That is what my skin looks like after the foundation. All right, guys, I am back. I finished my makeup around 10:40. It's been on for, it's now 10:48. It took me around 40 minutes to film my makeup, and then I had to go do something real quick, and now I'm back. So I've had this foundation on for roughly about 50 minutes. Let's go ahead and get into all the nitty gritty and all the information that you need to know about the foundation itself. FYI, when you get it, you need to shake it. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. All right. So it does come in its standard pump, 1 fluid ounce. The pump's really nice, really controllable. It's glass packaging, plastic pump and everything. I have the shade 10 Neutral Fair. It retails for $45. You can find it at Sephora. I imagine at some point you'll be able to find it also on Beautylish, because Beautylish carries Natasha Denona as well. There are 11 shades within the range, ranging from the lightest, which is the 10, which is what I'm wearing right now, to the darkest shade, which is number 90. She did mention when she first released this, I think like a day or so after she released it, that she is working on other shades for the range. So there will be some more lighter shades and there will be some more darker shades. That is what she has said on her Instagram, and she didn't give a date as to when those would be released, but that's what's going on right now. So let's quickly go over the colors and the tones that she has listed on her website right now. So right now she has 3 tones. She has warm, which is orange undertone. She has yellow undertone, and she has cool pink undertones. The orange undertones are number 30, 48, 70, and 90. The yellow undertones are 10, 20, 42, and 75. And the cool pink undertones are 40, 45, and 50. So cool undertones, you don't really get a big selection. If you're really fair, you're not gonna find a shade within the cool undertones for you. I have yellow undertones, and this number 10 matches me perfectly. I wish all my foundations were this color. It's a beautiful match. This foundation claims to be full coverage with a radiant finish that is long lasting, that will never cake, be heavy, or look thick. It is supposedly for all skin types. I have really dry skin, so if you have oily skin and you tested out this foundation, let me know down below how it worked for you so we can all get an idea. It also touts that it is has skincare ingredients in it. The skincare ingredients that I saw were grapefruit extract and pomegranate extract. Grapefruit extract is great at antibacterial, so if you have acne, this would probably be nice for you to use on a daily basis, as well as it's an alternative to tea tree oil. It promotes cellular health, and it's rich in vitamin A, C, E, and antioxidants. The pomegranate extract is an antioxidant rich, of course, and it's an anti-inflammatory. So for sensitive skin, that would probably be nice as well. However, I would like to mention that those are the last ingredients in this. So there's not too much skincare in this actual product, even though it says that it has a little bit of skincare in there. Just be aware that it is like the last two ingredients. Overall, I really like this foundation. I do not find on my dry skin that it has a radiant finish. You are seeing my face right now after I've done all my makeup. I do have a tutorial on this look. It will be coming soon after this video. But I'll zoom you guys in. But it doesn't look cakey. It looks really smooth and really nice. You guys saw the primer that I used in the beginning, which was the pore filling primer. And it doesn't look heavy. It just looks really, really nice. I will say that, like I said, on my dry skin, it has a really matte finish. So I wouldn't say that it was radiant by any means. So keep that in mind when you're looking at this foundation if you have dry skin. I don't know if it would be more radiant on an oily skin person, but for me, it's a really matte, powdery looking foundation. You do not need to set this foundation. It sets itself down. There is minimal transfer. I noticed it the other day because, like I said, I've been testing this foundation for a week or so now. I had transferred a little bit onto my husband's black coat when I gave him a hug. But it's not too much, and I think it was because it was still kind of drying at that point, but there's no transfer right now. But you could set it with a light powder to help with that. As per normal, I will be doing check-ins throughout the day. I will have this on my face all day, and you guys will come along with me and to see how it wears. All right, guys, it is 2:22. So this foundation has been on for about 4.5 hours now. I have gone and I've walked my dog and I've done a few errands. And it looks just like it did this morning. It's still looking really, really nice. It hasn't broken up anywhere. It hasn't kicked up anywhere. And it doesn't look heavy. I'm going to zoom you in so you guys can see my skin. And I'm going to scoot up some as well. There might be the normal wear right here. It is really cold out, so I was kind of blowing my nose and everything, so that's kind of normal to be worn away right there. But that is what it's looking like so far. I will be back in another, I don't know, later tonight sometime, and I will do my ending update and everything else. All right, guys, so it's time for my last check-in before the sun goes down. It's currently almost 7. I don't even know. You can't see it, but it's almost 7. It's like 6:55 or something like that. This foundation has been on for almost close to 9 hours now. And this is how it's looking. It's still looking pretty decent. I would still go out and do stuff in it. It's not breaking down anywhere. It's not clumping up anywhere. It's not looking particularly heavy on the skin. Of course, I have my glasses on, and per normal, it has worn off right here where the glasses hit, but it has not worn off around the cheeks as far as I can tell. Actually, let me get a mirror to make sure. Nope. It's just worn off where my glasses have been sitting. My concealer's actually starting to wear down, which is fine because I'm about to go wash this off my face because I'm ready for it to be off my face. It doesn't feel heavy or anything. It's just by a certain time of night, I just want my face to be loaded with oils. So let me zoom you in so you guys can get a look at it. Having a hard time focusing due to the lighting. It has rubbed off even more around my nose, but like I said, it's cold and I've been wiping my nose and blowing it, so. But other than that, it looks really good. It has, oh, stop going out of focus. So I would say if you were really curious about this foundation, I would definitely give it a try. It's lasted really well on the skin. It's medium to buildable coverage. It is matte. I would not say it's radiant. It's gotten more radiant throughout the day as it's meshed with my skin. But overall, it is a pretty matte foundation. It stayed really matte until about an hour ago. So up to the 8-hour mark, it was full on matte on my skin, except for where I put highlight on my skin. It's just now starting to get a little dewy, and I think if I were to wear it for a few more hours, probably for another 2 or 3 hours, it might actually start breaking down at that point. I typically don't wear makeup longer than 8 to 9 hours, so I hope you guys found this video helpful and informational. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.